lack of movement of capital implies that it's very difficult for, say, small and medium enterprises to find funding. They can only find it through banks, and sometimes that's difficult because they're too small. And the idea, again, is connecting savers and investors in an easy way.
Let's turn to this.
One of the problems of achieving a capital markets union in Europe is actually cultural. People are just not used to thinking about other ways of saving and investment. They were used to buying bonds, government bonds that had a very high yield, and that was it. Because this involves financial literacy, obviously countries with more sophisticated financial education will find it easier, but that's something that governments can push in the agenda.
Perfect.
This will take time. It's very hard to change people's habits, especially when it's about information and learning. It might take some time for people to realize that there are other options other than putting their money in the bank.
Thanks, Paul.
People are talking about the benefits but not about the risks. As a positive, more investment, which is one of the objectives of the Capital Market Union, but as a negative, people thinking through the Capital Market Union will have to consider seriously what will be the tools and measures to put in place in the event of a crisis, what macroprudential policies are needed and how they will react in the event of a crisis if they have an economy that is much more exposed to aggregate or systemic risk.